I grew up in a very conservative town. I grew up around adults that used to tell me things like, don't do marijuana, it'll kill you. And I would say, really? And they would say, no. But it'll lead you to doing other things which will kill you, which is just another way of saying that it'll kill you, but it'll take a long time to do it, which is just another way of describing all of life. Adults would say things like, don't have sex before you're married. And I would be like, really? Come on. And they would be like, no, you can't do it. And I would say, what about masturbation? And they would be like, still no, God doesn't like it. And I would be like, all right, I'm going to do it, but noted. And so then when I was 19, I had a girlfriend and I was like, well, she's lovely. I can just marry her and then I'll make her happy and it'll make my parents happy. But most of all, it would make God happy. Because I would finally stop masturbating all over the place. It's a win-win-win, you see. And so we did it, and it was lovely for a very long time. It was wonderful, until it wasn't, at which point I didn't tell anybody. And I just sort of like bottled it up and let it fester inside of me until eventually I blew the whole thing up. And now, to this day, you guys, I'm gonna be very honest with you, a lot of people believe that I actually had an affair before I ended my marriage. Yeah. Because I did. No. It's not good. It's not good. I don't recommend it. The water or the affair. I felt like I should mention the affair up top, you know, before we get too far into everything. Kind of wish I'd have done that the first time. Anyway, when it was found out, it was horrible. My whole life was just, it was demolished. I was wrecked with guilt. So I told everybody. I told my parents, and then I told my friends. I told my pastor, well, former pastor, because in the divorce, she got God. I think divorce and like separating from somebody, splitting up, breaking up, whatever you want to call it, I think it teaches you a lot about who the other person really isn't, you know? Like, before I'd separated from my ex, I thought she was this, like, very complex, very nuanced person, you know? Certainly with her own flaws, but a great sense of humor and, like an almost supernatural devotion toward me. But I still carried within me this sort of unspoken dissatisfaction with all of life. But then after we separated, and I would think about her, I would just be like, ah! You know, so it's not quite as nuanced anymore.